Chaparral High School. And Ed, it's a real pleasure to work with them. The piece that you just heard was Fanfare for the Common Man, and the important part of that is that if you look in the program, it doesn't say arranged by anybody. That's the original piece of music that was written for professional musicians, written for art for art's sake. In fact, as we talked about with the ensemble, Fanfare for the Common Man is written by Aaron Copland, not for nobles, not for kings, not for heroes of war or heroes of our culture. It's written for us, the common man that represents the United States, all of us here. And the reason why that didn't involve the woodwinds is because Aaron Copland usually wrote for orchestra. So he wrote that piece specifically just for the brass in the orchestra. So, and as I told the students, you know, yesterday, that maybe 1% of all high school students ever have the opportunity to play music of that caliber. And we had an amazing brass session, and they did a wonderful job. So thank you again to the brass. As Mr. Jensen told you a couple weeks ago, we had district honor band auditions. I'd like to take a moment and recognize the individuals in the ensemble who made that group. In our trumpet section, we have Nathan Burke. And Jacob Tell. And not here tonight, unfortunately, we also have Lacey Sue in our clarinet section. And me in our saxophone. So thank you to all those students who made district honor band. For those of you that were at the jazz concert last night, you know, I talked about my tie. Last night I had on this tie with Santa shoveling coal into stockings. As I guess I was kind of a curmudgeon or a Grinch, if you will, at Christmas. So my family, many years ago, gave me that tie. And so it's fortuitous now that we shall perform for you a little tongue-in-cheek, The Grinch. For everything she does for our program. She was an instructional aide here for many years, and now has moved into the registrar's office, but playing English horn for us on this portion of our concert. And the reason why we don't have an English horn player in the regular band is, well, we don't own an English horn. Welcoming to the stage, Miss Molly Murphy. So thank you so much. And I mentioned him earlier, but I just want to take a moment again to thank our other instructional assistant, Mr. Reese, for everything that he does. So thank you, Mr. Reese. And then we have one other instructional aide, Mrs. Carter, and we'd like to give her thanks as well. So thank you, Mrs. Carter. So, you know, we've talked a little bit about what a rare thing this is. And to have, you know, 4 or 5 concert bands, 2 jazz bands, a jazz combo, 2 instructional assistants. I mean, it's really a tremendous thing. And Chaparral High School hasn't always been like that. And, you know, I would also, because he's in attendance here tonight, thank Mr. Boyne, for all the tremendous work that he did to really build the program into what Chaparral is today, because he really did that. When he started here, it was a one-band school, and we appreciate everything he did, and we really appreciate him giving Mr. Jensen and I a call and saying, hey, come teach band in Nevada. So thank you so much to Mr. Boyne. All right, so I need to prepare you for this piece. And this is why. It's not avant-garde, it's not weird, but it is 15 minutes. So this next piece of music is 15 minutes in its entirety. And this is a huge, major work for a concert band. 10 years ago, I went to school at NAU to get a master's degree in conducting, you know, waving that baton stick thing around. I know you wouldn't think that you could get a master's degree in that, but you can. Cost money. And a master's degree in trumpet performance. And my intention at that time was, you know, I went back to school because I really wanted to teach college. I had already been teaching college on the side at the University of Arizona, and I went back to school thinking, you know, I'm gonna seek out a college job. And I was offered one when I went back to teaching high school in Arizona. And then the reason why I wanted to teach college was not because of the students, but because of the music. I really wanted the opportunity to do the kind of literature that college bands do. Literature that has purpose unto itself, not purpose that we're making for it. And what a privilege and pleasure it has been to work with the Wind Ensemble so far this year. I'm doing literature that Boise State University is doing on their winter concert, that BYU University is doing on their concert. So this is it. This is the real deal. This is college literature. So thank you to the Wind Ensemble for the opportunity to do that. I appreciate it. And lastly, a little bit about the piece. So, my wife's favorite hymn is What Child Is This, that you've already heard. And, you know, it's kind of a sad Christmas song. There are so many Christmas songs out there that are really, you know, boisterous and bold and joyous in their sounds. But What Child Is This is a little dark. You know, it's a little sad. This piece of music, obviously, comes from Russian hymns. They're all part of the Eastern Orthodox. And so many of them have this longing, lilting sound to them that you're going to hear a lot in the English horn and also in the clarinet lines. And of course, I always had thought about, you know, what that meant from a very kind of objective perspective that, yeah, you know, life is hard, having children is difficult. But about 7 months ago, my perspective on this piece of music changed. As 7 months ago, we welcomed our first child into the world. And as we're preparing this piece of music, it's not profound, but I had this thought that, you know, and we'll take all the religious aspect out of it because we can't really talk about that, but imagine if you, and all of you do, you know, you have children, and all you really want for them is not to suffer. But imagine if you knew that this child that you had was going to save everybody. They were going to do this really great thing. But in order to do so, they were going to suffer unbearable pain and die. And you know that as a parent before it all begins. So it kind of gives a different perspective on the time. And the music here is going to go from that kind of lilting, longing, melancholy to something that is truly glorious and powerful in the end. We hope you enjoy Russian Christmas music.